Chapter 6. This chapter will cover linear regression using Excel 2010. Most other versions of Excel, the regression function can be performed in the same manner. Linear regression is one of several cost estimation methods. It's used by managers to predict cost at various activity levels in much the same manner as the other methods of estimating cost behavior. It's a lot more accurate than the other methods because it uses all the data points. Ultimately, it fits a total cost line through the best fit data points. A cost equation is the output, and the cost equation will be in a format that's very similar to that used with the other cost estimation methods. The next screen has a detailed step-by-step approach to running a regression in Excel. We'll look at Excel in just a couple of minutes and walk through those steps. But first, let's take an example here. We have some cost and sales data for a company, and we're going to use regression analysis in Excel to determine the regression equation. The first thing we have to do is get the data into Excel. The data analysis tool pack probably is already installed, especially if you're using a computer on campus. If not, then you'll need to go through the appendix of this chapter to learn how to install it. The steps 4 and 5 ask you to select certain data. The cost column is the total cost, and we call this the Y range. This is the vertical if you're drawing a scatter graph. The other data is the activity, and we call this the X range, and this will be running horizontal on a graph. If we put this data into Excel, it will generate regression output. The regression output will look somewhat like this. A couple of issues that you want to look at. The first one, observations. This is how many data points did you put in? So our data contained 5 data points. So we have an output that generated, we have a regression that was generated using 5 data points. Down here in the lower left corner, we can find the information for our cost function. The intercept we know is total fixed cost, $5,841. And X variable 1 is the coefficient of the X. In this case, we round to 2 decimal points, 0.44. Now let's look at Excel. And I have a little bit different data here. This data has total cost based on the delivery of a company. So the first thing we're going to do is go up here at the top menu options and choose data. At the far right, there should be an analysis tab. If there's not, the data pack tool is not installed. I'm going to click data analysis and scroll down and choose regression and click OK. The cell pointer is in the first range called input Y range. The Y range is the total cost, so I'm going to select the total cost. The next field is the X data, input X range, and this is our activity. A number of these boxes here we will not be using in this course, but we do need to designate to Excel where to put the output. So we click the output range box and then select the field. We'll have a number of columns and a number of rows. So it's always best to choose a space in the worksheet where there's nothing below it and nothing to the right. I'm going to choose D2. If I click OK, the output for the regression is generated. Down here, we see the coefficients. Our formula will be total cost, or we could use Y equals 43.49x from the x variable 1. And to that, we're going to add 5,781. Fixed costs are a total amount, so we round to no decimals. The coefficient, which is a variable cost per unit, is a unit amount, so we rounded to two decimals. This concludes Chapter 6.